Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Welcome, welcome.
You know, it's all a bit mad.
All right, so little man is back. And so we're going to be going back into our Bible devotion really quickly. Father, we just want to thank you for this time that we're able to come once again to be in your presence. Lord, we know that it gives you joy and pleasure to see us come together, Lord, hearing from you, learning from you, Lord, taking instruction and really being transformed by your word. I pray that today, Lord, that you help us once again, Lord, that the lost will come to salvation, that the saved will be strengthened, Father, Lord, to continue in their run and in a fight with you, Lord. I pray that we as your people, Lord, we will not be deterred by the schemes of the devil, but Lord, that we will trust in your plan for our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Amen. It's been a blessing. I've had a wonderful day. You know, it's been a great day, man. I had a new tune today, a new song, so really excited about that. But once that comes out, I know that people are going to really enjoy that. It's a great song. It's a great song and has a great message with it as well. And so, yeah, man. I'm trying to find everything. I can't find anything, you know. Like, the phone came back different. I can't find even music. It's mad. Okay. What is this, man? Just trying to figure out the sound system here now. Because right now it's a bit mad. It's a bit mad right now. Let me see. Let me just jump on YouTube, innit? Let me see. Everything is pretty much new, and so when I open most things, it's just bringing me to setting up and all those things. So let me just get something out here. Okay, this is working. Library, history. Let's just play something from the history books. Okay, they've been going through a lot of it. Okay, that's probably not so bad, but I like this song. God is good, you know. Let's hear this. Can't remember the last time I heard it. It's mad.
Friday on her way to Cincinnati on a snow white Christmas Eve. Going home to see her mama and her daddy with the baby in the back seat. 50 miles to go and she was running low on faith and gasoline. It'd been a long, hard year. She had a lot on her mind and she didn't pay attention. She was going away too fast. Before she knew it, she was spinning on a thin black sheet of glass. She saw both her lives flash before her eyes. She didn't even have time to cry. She was so scared. She threw her hands up in the air. And Jesus, take the wheel, take it from my hands, 'cause I can't do this all.
Jesus, take the wheel. Pari and Arribo Sandere de Briambo, Rebe Briama, Sendere de Rabba Baba.
It was still getting colder when she made it to the shore and the car came to a stop.
Hey.
She cried when she saw that
baby in the backseat sleeping like a rock.
And for the first time
in a long time, she bowed her head to pray.
She said, I'm sorry. I've been living my life, I know I've got to change. It's over now, oh, tonight.
That's a beautiful song, man. Speaking about Jesus, take the wheel. It says, take it from my hands, because I can't continue on this path anymore. You know, she shares a story about somebody, driving to a hometown for like Christmas, things like that. You know what I mean? You're going over to family, you know, we just celebrated Christmas. And so, guess what? You're going down to family, you're excited. Sometimes, you know, it's these times where you've got a lot of things on your mind, and so, you know, there's a lot of things you're thinking about, you know, throughout the year, things you did right, things you didn't do right, you know, things, you know. Now, this woman, I believe it's a woman that she was speaking about, if it's not her own testimony, you know, this woman is going down, and this woman is alone in a car, and there's a baby in the back seat. You know what I mean? So from that story, you could even say that, you know what, the father may not be in that picture, you know, either by choice or, you know, maybe the father has just gone through a tragedy, you know, lost his life or something. That there is just, you know, there could be so many things that could be in this particular situation that is being depicted in the song. But it says that as this guy and that, you know, all these memories, all these thoughts, they're clouding this woman's mind. And, you know, before she knew it, it was basically a disaster. Do you know what I mean? You know, she couldn't handle it. She couldn't concentrate. She couldn't do anything. And so she lost control. But, you know, what she does in that moment is what we should do in every moment that, you know, really, you know, over our lives, you know, we shouldn't really wait for those moments to say, Jesus, take the wheel. I believe, so this song... it's weird because before, I remember, I think probably my A-level exam, it was one of the songs that I came across, you know, Jesus Take the Wheel, and I was so excited about that, you know, that I could have a song that says, you know, Jesus Take the Wheel, you know, I'm going to write an exam, Jesus, really, like, I need you to take the wheel kind of thing, and I was excited about that. And it's weird because today, you know, my sister had a friend over, and they were going through videos or something on my laptop, and so obviously my Google YouTube account is synced to the Google account on my phone, and so when I went on history on the YouTube's YouTube playlist, it brought this song up. You know, I have not listened to that song in so long, but obviously for some reason my sister and her friend they played it today. And the reason why it's so mad is that, you know, tomorrow, God willing, I've actually got an exam. You know, like, tomorrow, God willing, I've actually got an exam. And it's one of those things where, before, I used to join it. Hey, Kev, what are you saying, bro? Yeah, this is the live video that I do. It's always available. So I record it and put it online for people to read, to watch it, and to, yeah, man. Yeah, man. Hey, it's good to see you, though. It's good to see you. We need to link up very soon, very, very soon. I was speaking to Pamela the other day. So yeah, man, we need to link up very soon. I just got the phone today, actually. So I'm gonna start texting everyone. I just got the phone, it just came in today. So I'm going to start texting everyone on this number as well. And back to the thing. And so, yeah, it's one of those ones where it was strange because, you know, 3 years ago or something, I used to play this very song whenever I had an exam, you know, for Jesus to take the wheel. But really, it was just for that period. You know, I just thought to myself, you know what, it's a good song. I'm going to write an exam. I need Jesus to take the wheel. But it was almost like God was showing me that over my life, He needs to take the wheel in every aspect of my life. Not just when I've got an exam, not just when I've got a big interview, not just when I've got like a huge deal or something I believe is a huge deal. That's not the only time I should be coming to God and saying, God, you take the wheel. Is that I should be coming to God throughout my whole life. Do you know what I mean? Even today as I was singing it, it just came to me, you know what? You know, I was focusing in on the exam that I've got tomorrow, God willing. I was focusing on it, you know, Jesus take the wheel. And God just almost like just convicted me about, you know, listen, I'm taking the wheel over your whole life. And so if you truly believe that I'm driving your life and I'm controlling your life, you know, you shouldn't necessarily be focusing too much on this, because this is part of your life. This is part of the things that are going to come. And so, you know what? That one is sorted as well. And I believe it's a powerful thing for Jesus to take the wheel in everything that we do. Today, we're going to go through very quickly all the little things we're talking about 21 days of powerful breakthrough. Today is day, what is today? Day 8. And so day 8 of the 21 days of powerful breakthroughs. And today we're speaking about, Okay. Preparation reduces worry. Preparation reduces worry. It says, whatever it is you are hoping and expecting, it is important to be prepared for it. It says, how can you say, one day I will do this or that, but are lacking to put yourself in a position to be able to receive it? And in Jeremiah 31 verse 17, God says, there is hope in your future. It says, this lets us know that very thing you are hoping shall come to pass. Says, read Matthew 25, verse 6 to 10. You know, there are 10 women who set out on a journey, all expecting to meet the bridegroom to attend a marriage. You know, there is something very powerful about this passage. You know, all 10 were expecting. So if all 10 were expecting to meet the bridegroom, why is it only half were prepared? You know, so that, you know, when you read the story, there were 10 women preparing to meet the bridegroom. They had their lamps. You know, some of them brought extra oil for their lamps to be able to burn longer, but some of them just brought enough oil for a specific time. And so when the bridegroom was delayed, you know, they didn't have enough to go on. And it's one of those things where, you know, right now, obviously I'm preparing for the exam, and so, you know, revising and trying to learn a few things, you know, it's always good to learn more than needed, than, you know, try to learn just what you think is needed, because once you get into the exam, you don't necessarily know exactly what to expect. You know, you may have an inkling because, you know, these are the things that you've been learning, and so, you know, these are the things that are going to come up in the exam. But, you know, the expectations of some of the questions, how they may be, all these things, you know, because of that, you prepare a lot more than what you actually think you need. Do you know what I mean? These women, 5 of them, prepared longer than what, you know, the quota said they needed. So, you know, it wasn't necessarily wrong for them to bring enough for the journey. But, you know, it ended up costing them because they didn't prepare for, you know, any other things or any other factors going wrong or being delayed. It says a chosen few. Many times we, when we set out on our journeys with hopes, aspirations, and dreams, we may all start at the same place, but only a selected few obtain victory because of simply preparing in advance. You know, so what are you expecting from God today? It says, is it success in your job, a long and healthy life, a marriage, financial success, or simply peace? I'm expecting success in my examination. So that you do not only have to believe, but also start preparing yourself today. You know, preparation is definitely key and it's needed. It's key and it's needed. It says preparation reduces worry. And the Bible says, you know what? Do not worry about the things of tomorrow. It says tomorrow has got its own worries. You know, do not really focus on the things that are not yet here. But focus on the things that are here, because worry can deviate your attention from what you must do now. Do you know what I mean? And many times when we prepare, those worries go away. And I'm not just talking about preparing in terms of, you know, going through the book, you know, doing all the interview practices, but preparing in a spiritual manner as well, you know, prayer, you know, bringing it before God. You know, I just went to church this evening, and before I went to church, you know I've got this exam, I know I've been preparing a little bit for it, you know, and, you know, there are still things that, you know, today was a bit scary, actually. So when I started preparing, or when I started revising, there was an answer that I wrote up. You know, I went through a phase where I tried to go through past exam papers and, you know, try to write up what I could recall from memory at that time. And so, you know, I was writing up things. And today, I found one of the papers of some of the things that I wrote probably last week or last 2 weeks. And, you know, I thought to myself, my thoughts seemed way more collected than now. Like at the time when I read what I wrote at that time, it actually sounded put together. You know, now I just know about ideas and theories, and, you know, and it's just mad, because, you know, you start to think, you know, what level of preparation am I at? You know, and then I went to the house of God, and I went to meet with God, and I went to put my petition before God. I came before him in prayer, and I prepared this way. You know, the Bible says we prepare the horses for battle, but God gives the victory. God brings in the increase. And so, you know what? I'm still trying, you know, I'm going through things, I'm repeating things, I'm doing all I can, you know, physically, but reality is there is a deeper dimension, and we need to trust God to help us in the things that we expect him to, you know, we expect breakthrough in. You know, we need his help. It says, take time today to list 5 things you've been expecting and praying for from God. Next to each item, list what preparations you can begin to take in order to be prepared to receive it. You know, every prayer needs a preparation. You know, every prayer that we pray to God, or everything that we're really, you know, trusting God for, we should be preparing ourselves to receive the answer for that. You know, the answer may be a no, it may be a yes, it may be a, you know, wait a little bit, but in all instances and in all cases, we must be prepared that, you know, whatever answer comes, you know, it's either we're going to trust God, you know, we're going to trust God either way, but, you know, I mean, the trusting God to move forward, or trusting God to let certain things go, you know, that there's different factors and different things that we think about, but, you know, really just there is a need for preparing. There is a need to, you know, get our hearts right, get our minds right, you know, just let God handle things. You know, we're doing our bits, but God is God. You know what I mean? God is God. Father, we just want to thank you for this timely word, Lord, that you spoke into us, Lord. We know that as we seek you, Lord, as we pray and as we ask for things, Lord, that you are faithful, Lord, to bring them, Lord, to pass, Lord, in our lives, to that they will be manifested. I pray, Lord, that whatever battles that we may be facing, Lord, even as I go to write my examination, Lord, whoever is writing that exam, Lord, whoever is preparing for any other thing, Lord, I pray, Lord, that you will help us, that our preparations, Lord, will be blessed, that our preparations, Father, will be multiplied, Lord, that we will see fruit come out of it, Lord. I pray that you will guide us and lead us in the places to even to prepare. You give us ideas, Father, Lord, on things to focus on during our preparations towards the receiving of our prayers. I pray that you just have your way in us, continue to lead us, continue to grant us your peace, Lord, a peace that surpasses all understanding, that, Lord, that we will know, Lord, that with you, we're more than prepared for every journey that we embark on. We thank you, we bless your holy name, in the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. Blessings, it was amazing today. Really hope that you know, I pray that God continues to reveal himself to us and help us to grow. And we'll be meeting back here again tomorrow, God willing. So if you're watching this on demand, actually, you know, keep me in prayer as well. Yeah, man, let's go do this. Bless.